like it.
That's because you're a toupee.
Sport coat and a faint carnation.
Morning, Phil. You're early today. It's only 11:30.
So have you been looking for it?
Wally Curry was in looking for that lemon yellow you promised to grind.
Aye, and Spanky told me you had diarrhea and you'd take a big dish out of him later on.
Aha, there you are, laddie. Where have you been this morning? I thought all there says you were unwell.
Yes.
Well, come on, McCann, what was up with you?
Touching a draw hole.
The what?
The skitters. It was very bad.
Well, why didn't you come to see me earlier? I could have got nurses to have a look at you.
Well, it's not what you'd call a spectator sport.
In future, you report all illnesses to me, first thing. How am I supposed to keep tabs on you slab boys when I don't know where the devil you are, eh?
I was doing the lab.
You wouldn't get much done down there.
Oh, I wouldn't say that, Mr. Curley.
God's truth, I've had you chaps in Burma. Diarrhea! There were men in my platoon fighting the Japanese with dysentery.
Is that how we managed to beat them, Mr. Curley?
Less of your cheek, Farrell. A couple of years in the forces might knock some damn sense into your heads. What have I told you about bringing that contraption in here? Bloody tom-toms! Whoever belongs to this can ask Mr. Barton for it back. Right, I'll be back in 5 minutes now. Get on with your work.
He's chirpy this morning, eh?
Oh, Eyeless. Am I all muttering me? How's she going to hear what happens to the archers now?
This is the slab room, Alan. Last stop on the tour. This is where the powder paint is ground and dished for the designers. You saw the paper patterns out there. The lads here divvy up some colour from those big drums. Rose pink, magenta, Persian yellow. Dump it onto these slabs, add some gum arabic. Do we have some gum arabic, Hector? Oh, Hector, this is Alan. Alan Downey, Hector McKenzie.
Aye.
Now, one needs just enough gum to prevent the paint from flaking off the drafting paper. And then it's just a case of grinding to get rid of the impurities, OK? Would someone like to dish that? You'll be pleased to hear you won't be having too much contact with these unsalubrious surroundings. Mr. Barton's put you in with Bobby Sinclair. His department's a bit more wholesome than this one.
When are you off, Jackie boy? Not wanting to rush you or that?
George Farrell, known to one and all as Spanky.
Aye, Blooky Chops, them boils of yours are highly smittled.
No need to get personal.
Oh, get away from me. Hector, fling us out of the dettle.
This is all because I'm in a desk.
It's a bloody operating table you want to be on. Oh, that face.
And you can put in for plastic surgery, you know.
Or a pimplectomy.
It would only take about 6 months.
And a team of surgeons.
With pliers!
I'll have to go now, Alan. Sorry, there's a couple of trials I've got to have a look at. The boss would like you to show Alan what goes on here in the way of work.
What did you say your name was again, son?
Alan. Alan Downey.
Okay, Alma. Let's show you something of the mysteries of the slab room. Mr. Farrell?
Yes, Mr. Mack.
Just showing Alphonse here some of the intricacies of our work. I wonder if you and the boy there would care to staunch to the man's side and keep it to the road.
Certainly. Hector.
Thank you. Right, Alec. Now, this here is what we cry a sink. S-I-N-K. Now, I don't expect you to pick up all these terms immediately, but you'll soon get the hang of it. And here? It's what we cry, a slab boy. You say it?
Slab boy.
Good. Note the keen eye, the firm set of the jaw, forced up under cucumber frames, you know. Note two, the arse hanging out, the trousers. This last because the slab boy is expected to put in a full 8 hour sweated labour a week for a few measly shillings.
And all the gum crystals you can eat.
Hence the firm set of the jaw. Don't you wish you was one of this happy breed, Andrew, grinding out those spanking shades for our designer chappies so that they, in their turn, can churn out those gay little rugs one sees in our more select stores. Don't you wish you was a slab boy?
Sounds like fun, but Mr. Barton's put me in with Bobby Sinclair.
How much you getting?
£3 a week was suggested.
£3 a week? But that's more than us lot get put together.
Is Wallace Bathroom your uncle or what?
Wallace Barton, the boss.
Of course he isn't.
How much did you get in your last job?
I haven't had a job before. I'm at the uni.
Yeah?
The university. I've only just left school.
What age are you?
19.
Did you get kept back a lot?
Hey, cut it out, you pair. Don't pay any attention to them.
Less of the collaboration, kiddo. We fought two world wars for the likes of you.
Aye, that lad there lost a couple of legs at Wipers.
So that the world would be a cleaner and better place.
Where a man could walk tall.
Legs and no legs. Hey, where's Sadie with that trolley? I'm starving. Hey, Alvaro, you got the time?
It's almost quarter past.
And what's the wind speed at the top of the Eiffel Tower?
What are all those jars and things over there?
Gosh, Alfred, I thought you would never ask. Well, this in here contains the mortal remains of one Joe McBride, the oldest slab boy in the long history of this illustrious company. Going on for 84 was Joe, when they finally made him a designer. Of course, the shock was too much for the elderly chap. And when the cleaners arrived in the design room on Monday morning, they found the veteran slab boy slumped over his newly acquired desk, stone dead. His hoary old pate in a jar. A jar of freshly ground indigo. You know what they say, Arthur?
What's that?
When you indigo, you indigo! Sorry I took so long, Alan. Bit of bother with one of the trials. Fancy a recce rounder at works?
Yes, smashing. Yeah, get in and out quick, mind. The wee hairies will eat you alive. They're like piranhas. Mind you, you'll be all right with Jackie Boy. None of the lassies go near him. They'll dive under the looms as soon as they see his kisser.
I'm going to ignore all that. I don't wish to bandy words with the likes of you.
We don't wish to bandy legs with the likes of you, torn face.
You thinking half your heat's catching, Spanks?
What, you mean like Jack's plucks?
No, I'm serious.
You're mugging.
Aye. They took her away last night. She wasn't all that bad either. No for her, that is. All she did was put in the cooperative windies and run up the street with her hair on fire.
How long she been for this time?
The usual 6 weeks, probably. First week tied to a rubber mattress, the next five wired up to a generator.
Shocking.
No, that's when we get in to see her, when she's undergoing that SSEB treatment. Never knew the last time. Kept crossing herself with Lucozade and asked my father if he was aiming leave. My old man, he's hopeless. He thinks it's like diphtheria or that. The doctors are doing their best, Annie. You'll be home soon. Taking that medicine and give you. Medicine. An injection of Benzedrine if they fall asleep and a good bathroom if they don't.
Much bother when they took her away last night?
Nah, they gave her a jag to knock her out so they could sign her in as a voluntary patient.
Who is responsible for this, sir? Come on, which one of you geniuses is responsible for this mess, sir? Look at that paper, look at it. Feel it gone, feel it. It's like damn rough cast. This colour has just been thrown onto a slab willy-nilly, whisked round a couple of times and dished. No damn gum, nothing. It's a disgrace. Things were a damn sight different when I first started in the slab. 12 and 6 a fortnight, and we regarded it as a privilege. We was learning a trade.
Well, what trade was that, Mr. Curry?
Any more cheek out of you and you'll be up in front of Mr. Batten before you can say Axminster Broadloom. And you, Farrell, what have I told you about smoking? Miss Walkinshaw found 2 dog ends in the rose pink yesterday. No, just 1, 2. What have you got to say to that?
They were meant to be Emerald Green.
This slab room used to be my pride and joy, not anymore. Jimmy Robertson out there was showing Mr. Barton a paper, a contract Persian for Canada. He held the pattern up and his scrolls dropped up. And that colour cabinet out there is half empty.
It was half full this morning.
Look, I want these slabs glowing red hot, or there'll be trouble, big trouble. I'll be back.
Do you think I should have jumped in and asked him for a desk?
You might have been lucky to go to your books.
What did you say was wrong with you this morning, McCann?
Severe diarrhea, Mr. Curry.
If you expect me to swallow that, you're very much mistaken. I'm putting a report into Mr. Barton, and you, McCann, are top of the list, and you can wipe that grin off your face, Farrell. You're on the list, too.
What for? What have I done?
What, like your pal there, as little as you think you can get away with? Well, I'm no standing for it. That colour cabinet down there speaks for itself.
Oh, talking furniture.
Wait a minute, I'm not supposed to fill it by myself. What about them? What about Hector? You never said nothing to him.
You, Mackenzie, I'll see you later in my office.
What you going to say that for? You're a rotten big bastard, so you're...
Shut your face! I'm buggered if I'm going to carry the can for the colour cabinet being empty.
Off empty, don't exaggerate.
Oh, well, it's not my job. I can only fill it by myself. And look at these dishes.
What was up you were late anyhow?
She hurt the police with the alarm cloak.
Hurt the police?
Aye, they got a phone call for the manager of the co about his windies. They knew where to come. It's the third time.
Does she not like the coal?
We got all your clays for there.
It was a bit of love it suit that our gym got. When they got it home, it had only one leg in the trousers and the bastards wouldn't exchange it. Said it was something to do with the nap of the cloth.
And what did you do? Amputate?
And no, Jimmox just had to shove both legs into the one trouser. Gave him a kind of swivelling mince, that was the only thing.
I used to wonder about your gym, that must have been where it was.
He used to arrive home for the jigging. 20 sailor boys in his wake.
I had an Uncle Bertie that was in the Navy.
Oh, here we go again. We know, he'd been doing with his boat.
Ship. The Royal Oak. His photos in the mantelpiece. He was only 19.
Hector, nobody mentioned your Uncle Bertie.
He was my mother's only brother.
No, you've got his medals in the press and his clays up on the wall.
Is his clays that are in the press
and his... For God's sake!
And he died for his country!
OK, Hector, OK. Look, I was only kidding about the 20 sailors. Honest. It was 40.
You bloody bastard! He's of no regard for nothing, neither you have. My uncle is a volunteer, straight onto battleships for the Sea Scouts. And he was wounded twice. Before he was killed.
Nice wee fairy cake. What's wrong with yous? Come on, you teaser. Where's my Wayne? Come and see what your mammy's brung you. That's for being a good boy.
Oh-ho.
There's only the one. The rest for the boardroom. I get Miss McDonald to put an extra one on for my baby.
Come on, Sadie!
Oh, shut it, yous! That way needs a wee treat. There's fairy cakes for you.
He's a bite,
huh? You leave my for Wayne Elaine, you pair of hooligans. Enjoying that flower. That's the stuff. Now, come on, yous two. What do you want? Tea or coffee?
Tea.
Tea, right.
He's one of your fairy cakes. Fairy's been putting cement in him again. He's a coffee.
Please. What's your manners? Your mothers would be ashamed of you, so they would.
Oh, I say, look what's just strolled in, Terry. That ballybounder that's fagging for Spotty Jack.
Bless my belter if you ain't right, Nugent.
I think I'll try a tea, please.
See that? There's a showing up for you. There's what you cry, manners. Are you in beside these boys?
Just temporarily. I'll be in Bobby Sinclair's department.
Very nice. And you never put your money in the tin. Come on, 3 pence for tea, 4 pence for coffee. I said 4 pence, come on.
I've only got a tanner.
It's all right, I've got plenty of coppers. And when did you start, son?
This morning.
What did they cry you?
Albert.
Agnes.
Alan.
Dowdy.
Doodles.
Blowney.
Look, son, I come round every morning and afternoon with the tea. I'll try and bring you something nice after dinner time.
Thanks very much.
Sadie.
Sadie.
I thought we could learn you savages a thing or two. You stick in, son. You'll go places. Now, have you got your tickets for the staff dance tonight?
Christ, is it the night?
Stop that. Aye, it's the night, and I don't see your name doing here as Pied. Come on, stump up.
Sadie, have a heart. But I give you my last tanner. But I'll pay you next week.
You'll pay me after dinner time, or you'll horn your ticket back. Now, you boys get plenty. How might you doing for this afternoon?
You still gone, Phil?
I suppose so.
You get your spanky.
Aye.
Hey, to what about you, son? I don't see your name doing here. You ain't miss this year. Do you know what, one, son?
How much are they again?
15 shilling the single, 25 the double.
I'll take the double.
What?
I said I'll take the double.
That's what I thought you said, son. Here. Seeing both of yous have a lovely time. What about you, sweetheart?
Well, I hadn't thought about it.
Well, you always know who's got the tickets if you date. Oh, I better wait. Them directors will be greeting if they don't get their cookies. Two, thanks, son. Well, thanks, son. You're a real gentleman. Thanks. That's just your ticket money to give, Phil McCann.
Aye. Hector, you didn't need to go that far. I know we were giving you the needle and that, but you didn't have to go and throw 25 bob away in a ticket just to get your rain back. We never said your Uncle Bertie was like that. Disney running families anyhow.
Aye. No, look, lunacy.
Hey. He said he knows that.
Coach, he started it.
Who are you going with anyhow, Heck? Him do we know? There's no walnut face for the postess, is it? Come on, Hector, who's Miss X?
Mind your own business.
There's no Miss Walkinshaw. There's no Miss McBurnell with the big cookies. Doesn't leave much to choose for. No, I think it's a big kid on. What do you say, Phil?
If he's my snow, it's Lucille Bentley.
What? Lucille Bentley?
Lucille would never consider going to the staff dance with you, Hector.
Lucille and you, Hector?
What's that?
Well,
where did you get the pattern?
Come on, all of a sudden.
Well,
she said that.
Poor Hector.
God, I'm busting.
I'd have believed her. Oh, what do you make of that, Spanks? He wasn't off hiding his light, eh?
Hey, couldn't he be now he was hiding?
But one of you clatty gannets has been in at Miss Walkinshaw's lunch pail. Her sardine and chutney sandwich is covered with Rossi in it and her oranges went missing. You greedy pig, so you are. You know she's got a caliper. Is there any of them dish rags? Dish rag.
Voila. You've just missed him.
Love her by.
Who?
The economy size Casanova. He just went out.
He's a wee guy, but that height. You're looking forward to the dancing, right, Lucy?
What are you talking about?
Hector.
So?
So you've just missed him. We're just letting you know.
Thanks. Is that supposed to be significant, or am I just being thick? Can you translate all that?
I think the meaning about you and Hector going to the staff dance.
What? Me and who?
Hector.
Hector? Going to the... Who's been giving you that, guff? It's the staff dance, not the teddy bear's picnic. You mean somebody actually said that I was going with?
Aye, somebody actually said.
Don't make me laugh. Hector, seemed better hanging off a Christmas tree.
Oh, here it comes. Prince Charming.
You shall go to the ball, Lucille.
What was all that mouthwash you were giving us about you and Lucille going to the staffy, you little tolly?
You mean him believing you? She's just been in here.
You never gave us a chance to explain.
What's to explain? You led us to believe that you and her were going to cut her up tonight.
Oh, well, I was going to ask her.
Well, that's what I thought he meant, that he was going to ask her.
Who cares what you thought, sonny boy? You just stand there and model that blazer.
I didn't actually say that I had asked her.
Ah, well, you certainly gave me and Spanks the impression that you had.
Well, it struck a wrong chord with me at the time that a doll like Lucille would want to partner something like you to the dance. I mean to say, look at you. Heck, you are a mess.
What's up with me?
But everything's up with you. Look at the state of your clays for a start.
There's nothing up with my clays.
There's nothing up with my clays. You must be joking. I've seen more up-to-date clays in the garden gnome. Style, heck, that's what counts. Style.
Well, I can't really agree with that.
You throwing your voice, Phil?
Don't let them bully you. Clothes are perfectly all right.
Oh, I've found where the voice is coming for you, Spanks.
Oh, creepy breaks here. And what do you know about clays? Because you're nearly as bad as him. Look at the trousers.
Phil, have a gander at the shoes.
God almighty, Alice, what's that you've got on your feet?
Well, they're better than those efforts you're wearing.
The all-British bubble boot, endorsed by Dermot Walsh.
That is the very boot that conquered Everest.
And you're comparing them to a stupid-looking pair of brogues.
What's wrong with brogues?
Well, they're full of holes, for a start.
Well, Alan.
With hogs for zog.
Did you really mean that about style? Clays and all that stuff. Kidding aside.
I'm afraid we did, son. I mean, what dame is going to take a guy seriously with a head like that, heck?
Well, I can't help the way my hair grows.
That's where you're wrong, kiddo. Mr. McCann. And don't worry about the clays. We'll organise something with him. Said he's got a singer in the ladies.
No, I don't...
Do you want to go to Staffy with Lucille?
Oh, but...
Then leave it to Mr. McCann and myself. His Auntie Faye used to be a tailoress, you know.
In the dolls' hospital.
Right, Phil. Do you want to take our client down to the lavies and get the clays out?
I will do
it. Wait a minute, Hector.
Wait a minute, Hector. Wait a minute,
Hector.
The lavies.
All on your own here, George. Couldn't find Bobby Sinclair anywhere, so I thought Alan could come and do a spot in the slab room.
Flair's just been mopped.
If I see Bobby, I'll tell him where you are, Alan.
Where's Mackenzie?
Phil took another attack and Hector to go with him.
Attack or what, for God's sake? Another loose stools again.
Hector to give him a call leading the stairs.
God almighty. What are you doing here, young fella? I thought you were seconded to Bobby Sinclair.
Jack and I couldn't get hold of him, Mr. Curry. He wasn't in his office.
That's truth. This place gets me like the Mary Celeste every day.
Very
You're
good,
not
Mr.
too big for a clip round the ear, Farrell. Right. Last sheet of paper, if you please. Is that what you call a large sheet?
That's all we've got.
Ellen, nip down to the design room and ask Mr. Brennan for a large sheet of paper. On you go. Right, you got any tracing paper?
Tracing paper?
Tracing paper?
For tracing?
Just so.
No.
What happened to that row Mr. Barton left?
No trace of it.
Steady, Curry. How's that gum coming along, Farrell? I take it that is gum you're making.
Aye, there was an awful lot of straw in that last lot of crystals.
Probably camel chips.
Eh?
Dung, laddie. Yes, many's the night we spent huddled over the old camel chip bonfire after a hard day's trek across the dunes. Can get a mite chilly of a desert evening, you know. Impacted dromedary droppings crackling merrily away, sending a fountain of bright sparks swinging into the velvet skies. Some of the lads would even get their ukuleles out.
Hey.
We'd have a sing-song. I don't suppose you were ever in the scouts. No. We'll meet again. Don't know where. Don't know. Do you know the Vera Lynn's caravan caught up with us at one time? Tommy Christo's Rialto Kinema Alexandria. 10 minutes from the tram depot. Yes, a lovely girl. We were all there that night. 1,500 Highland Fusiliers waving our pashas in the dark and shouting, we'll give the buggers what for, Vera. A lovely girl. She wore the kilt that night. For I know we'll meet again. Samsa.
See that, Mr. Curry?
Ah, there you are, lad. Just set it down here. Now then, I'm going to run over a few pointers with you. You'll be wise to pay particular attention. You too, Farrell, you might learn something. You're never too long in the tooth to learn how to execute a Farrell floral. Now, charcoal.
Hey.
Charcoal.
How can I get charcoal with my horns or gum?
If you tell me where it is, I'll get it myself.
We haven't got any.
Alan, nip out and ask Mr. Robertson for some willow charcoal. On you go. Oh, and a chamois.
Which one's Mr. Robertson?
Third desk from the window, moustache, briar pipe.
Is that no Miss Walkinshaw?
On you go, Alan.
I'm sorry, Mr. Curry, I've forgotten what to ask for.
Willow charcoal and a chamois. Farrell. Farrell. What's this business about McCann's Mallard? Do you know anything about it? Miss Walkinshaw's got a brother-in-law, a shop manager in a housing scheme. He was telling her about some carry-on last night. McCann's mother was involved. Fir Trees Crescent, they lived on there.
No. No, no, they'd moved. Couldn't even Phil's mother put in the window. It must have been some other loony.
Thank you, Farrell.
Here we are, Mr. Curry.
Ah. Was that all they had?
No. And a chamois.
I find it difficult to picture this making its way sure-footedly up the treacherous slopes of the Matterhorn. Still, I suppose it'll have to do. Right.
Telephone, Mr. Curry.
Buggeration.
No, information. It's an outside call from Glasgow.
Wait there, laddie. I'll be back.
Are these yours?
No, they must be Phil's. Hey, you better put them back. If Phil catches you going through his stuff, he'll break your jaw. You better close that folder.
Some of these are very good. Quite accomplished.
Oh, quite accomplished, are they? What do you know about it?
Not a great deal. Anyone can see they're rather good.
I'm warning you, if Phil comes back...
Hey, that's what do you call him, isn't it?
Aye, Elvis. Dead like him, isn't it?
Yeah. Just be having a word with your dad on the telephone, Alan. You didn't realise Bob Downey was your father, eh? Chief designer at Templar's. He certainly come out in the world since he left here, eh?
Hello, hello. What's this, sir? Some of your artwork. Dad been giving you a few lessons, eh? What's this? Glasgow School of Art, first year entrance examination, summer 1957.
They're not mine, Mr. Curry.
Aye, they're no his.
I would just have
them. Who do they belong to, then? Certainly not yours, Farrell. You've traveled trying to draw water for that tap there. What's this? P.J. McCann, 10 Fertrees Crescent, Fergusley Park. Farrell!
What?
Away down in the Blushens and fetch that crony of yours up here.
I'll have to wash my hands first.
Get the mitts washed there. Right then, Alan. Now, what is the first thing we do when starting a charcoal sketch?
Yeah, about a charcoal.
That is right. Get the wrist moving. Make sure it is good and supple before you even begin to make a mark. Got it? Look with your fingers. There, and I feel that, right? See what I mean, eh?
Ah, oh, yes.
Am I interrupting something? I'll come back later.
Ah, there you are, McCann. Bowels back to normal?
Eh? Oh, eh?
It's nice of you to call in. Perhaps you can enlighten us or something.
Hey, what are you doing with these drawings? That's
private. There is nothing private in here, lad. What is this? Glasgow School of Art entrance examination. Well?
You've near right. That portfolio is mine. I collected it this morning.
So that's why you were more than an hour late, eh? That diarrhea business was just a red herring.
It's the mirror told you about the diarrhea. It was him.
You bastard.
I smelt a rat as soon as you walked in that door. You were up collecting this little lot. Now, I don't wish to accuse you of being underhand, friend, but don't you think it might have been wise to ask permission before...
But you must be bloody joking. Whose permission do I need? Yours?
Or Mr. Barton's?
Ah, shall we?
Watch it, lad! Just you remember who you're talking to. Any more of that and it'll be your judgment.
Excuse me, interrupted, Mr. Curry. You're right on the telephone.
Right.
Right
away. Right. Right.
Whose permission is bloody? Did you hear him, Spanks?
You didn't need to go in shoppers like that, did you?
What are you talking about?
I was only trying to stop you from getting into trouble, oh, some thanks I got.
That isn't important. Did you hear what that little keek said about me going to the art school?
Oh, that's what all the noise was about.
I Curry was making out I was being devious because I was wanting out of here.
I never knew nothing about it.
Well, I don't have to tell you everything there.
Oh? You told us about your ma.
It's a pretty tough entrance exam, you know. I've tried it. Don't let too many in.
That's right. No, my father says...
Who cares what your father says? He'll have as much idea as Pansy Pluck there.
Oh, wait a
Come
minute.
Come on, the boy was always
saying... I knew you were turning me a hooer. I bet it was you that showed Wally Curry my folio.
What the hell?
It was me, if you must know. And I didn't do it deliberately.
And I tell him to leave it alone, didn't I?
I don't see what all the fuss is about anyway. Time enough when the results come out. I've got a friend sat the exam and she says you don't hear till next month. You get a letter through the post.
Bully for her. Well, I'll be hearing sooner than that. In fact, I'll know by this afternoon.
How come if Jack's China is
not? Last seen the office at the art school. Said she'd give us a ring. I gave her the number.
This number?
Aye.
Well, I don't see Willie Curry passing it on. He doesn't allow any personal calls, and this is a matter of life or death.
I tell her to say it was the hospital.
They're not supposed to do that. It seems really unfair. Other people have to wait.
I'm no life. Other people, Jack.
Well, I still think it's unfair. Don't you, Alan?
Piss off, pimple chops. Way back to your desk and fester.
I don't think you should speak to Jack like
it's
that.
It's all right, Alan. Thanks, Justice.
Don't speak to anybody anyway. I like bugger lunch. Why
leave him, Phil! He's just a creepy shitebag, isn't he, Herman?
I think I'll get a breath of fresh air.
I think you better.
Hey, it'll blow her. You know what Willie's like.
The McCann's come up here, will you, McCann?
Oh, I thought he was up here already.
You tell him to come to my office the moment he appears.
See what I mean? It's Hectorage going in for no you. It's a bloody shame, Phil. You and me got off light compared with Heck.
Oh, aye, I noticed. You think it is his card?
That's the second time he's asked to see him the day. What do you think?
Aye. Now, where is he, anyhow?
Who?
Hector.
I thought he was doing the bog with you.
Aye, he was, but he managed to get free.
Free?
I had him tied to a radiator. He managed to chew through the ropes while I was
you
away.
You mean he's wandering about without a stitch?
He's got his simmer on. That didn't need restyling.
He'll get bloody frostbite, swine. How could you do that?
It was your idea, no, don't forget.
Come on, how are we going to find him?
Easy. Follow the trail of blood.
Blood?
I gied his ear a wee nick with the shears when I was cutting his hair.
You're a sadist, Phil.
I try and get the guy a date while he's healing, that's the thanks you get.
Oh, some chance he's got now. Who'd want to go to the dance with a one-year baldy-headed midget and a bloodstained scimitar? Huh?
Does that mean it's lunchtime?
No, it's dinner time, Creep.
Don't think you're sitting beside us. The grub's enough to pick you off your dinner. I'll get the togs for Sadie Stein. She's got a big job in her hands. Lock it, Stater.
Last man doing the canteen's a designer!
I told you not to have the salmonella and toast.
I think I'm going to be sick.
Ah, well, don't hang out the shades. There's gum in them already.
Quite a nice lunch to do. Bobby Sinclair's tied up at the moment with some problem hanks, so I thought I might do some grinding. Well, what's wrong with that? I want to learn as much as I possibly can whilst I'm here.
You haven't been drinking, have you?
I don't mind. I'll just go and let Mr. Curry know I'm not needed.
Yeah. Put the other horn there. That's sketchy. You're a natural, kid. Me and Phil will lie out here and watch you for a bit.
When you've got that dish, there's some green there.
Thanks.
Oh, don't mention it. Here, you want a drag?
I don't smoke.
Surprise. Young Danny working away and you two Terry boys lounging back having a puff. I've often wondered how a pair of greasy, quiffed Nancy boys like you would have fared under fire. Slant eye snipers up every second palm tree, drawing a bead on us jocks as we cut and hacked our way through the dense foliage. What was you done then, eh? Is this what Wingate gave up his last gasper? Because a couple of louts like you could get yourselves a cushy number? Come on, McCann. Don't just sit there like G.I. Joe. Get on with it. This way, Alan.
My 40 years giving the Japs Merry Jip. Memoirs of Jungle Jim.
Japs, my arse. Jimmy Robertson told me. Willie was a typist in the pay corps. Nearest he go to Burma was a bamboo tea lounge in Inco Street.
He's a wee blowhard. He doesn't scare me.
Look out!
What's Alan around?
The old fat guy, scarlet fever, and his nose in a sling.
Would you tell him, George, I've got those mags he was asking about?
What mags are these, Jack?
They're about design. I didn't think you'd be interested.
Tell him, Spanks. Are we interested?
No, not really.
Exactly. So think twice before you lurch in here and accuse the brother and me of not giving a monkey's. The designing of carpets for the hoi polloi may mean nothing to you, Hog, but it means a damn sight less to us. Right, Mr. Raff?
Right, Mr. Mack.
You're so smart, aren't you? The two of you, so smart. You're jealous of anyone that takes an interest in things. You know about Hector when he first started? He used to come out to my desk and we'd go through some carpet mags together. But you put a stop to that, didn't you? Said he was a sook. Called him for everything. A pair of bully boys. That's what you are. Hector could have made a pretty good designer if it weren't for you. Better than either of you anyway. When was the last time you were down the showroom, eh? Neither of you take the least interest in any trials that come up. I bet you don't even know what they're working on out there.
14 and 11 pence a square furlong.
That's right. Make a fool of things. Go on. Some of us take a pride in what we do.
Some of us take a pride in what we do. You're the first one out the door in the leg or the bike before Miss Walkinshaw's even got her teeth out her water jug.
I went to night school for 3.5 years. I've got a diploma in wool technology.
So what does that mean?
He's hand-knitted.
There's no point talking to you morons. And there's more gum wanted out here.
Ah, your hair will paste
you. I think I'll be doing the showrooms and have a swatch at the new rugs, Phil.
You're joking.
God, the four. I'll have a look for heck.
Jack Hogue. He's sitting out there with his face like off chewed penny dainty.
Well, it's clearing up, is it?
Bernadette's boyfriend's going to come up here and give you and your pal a doing if you don't hang off.
Hang off, he what?
Jack Hogue, they went to school together.
Oh, tremble, tremble.
He's nearly 6 foot and he's got a yellow belt. It's only Bernadette that's holding him back for coming.
Oh, she's a Catholic.
Pardon? Come in here for a gun at my road. Is this it? The fresh stuff? This could be out for its Halloween. You're a bunch of lazy...
Now, don't you start. Wally's been on at us all morning. We're up to here with castigations.
No wonder. God, look at the state of this sink. It's at the inside of Miss Walkinshaw's makeup bag. People could get a disease for this.
Lucille, I was wondering if you would like to...
Like to what?
Go to the staff dance with me the night. Well, I'm not like Jimbo Dean, but...
Hector! For Christ's sake, Paul! What is that? I'm going to lose my grip in a minute.
What are you doing out there? We're 3 flares up!
Climbed up the wrong pipe. Where's my clays?
Yeah, I'll nip along and see if they'll be ready. Now, you stay there.
Holy Curry. Quick, get in that cupboard.
Oh, Grace.
Shh,
oh.
Quick.
That's his little hidey hole, isn't it? Come on. That's Mackenzie's little hidey hole, isn't it?
How did you know?
It's forever secreting great parts of it in there.
Huh?
Fresh gum, laddie. Where is it?
There.
Where?
There.
How?
Thanks, Hector.
Can I come out now?
No, you just stay there a couple of minutes. I'll nip along and see if your clothes will be ready. I'll no be long.
Hey, sign of the wee mat.
Is that you, Al?
Eh?
Suppose it's
there. Who is that?
It's me. Hector.
Are you dead?
God almighty, Hector, you're hid.
What's up? Is it bad? Oh, Mommy!
Killing me, Jack.
Shh, somebody's coming. Quick, back in your cupboard.
Oh, Spank, you've got to try and find your...
Shh. Shh. Definitely saw something there, definitely. Outside the window. It's a horrible face like one of them gargoyles with great big staring eyes.
Well, there certainly doesn't seem to be anything there now, Lucille. You're positive about this face.
Swear to God. Hideous.
But we're 3 stories up. I don't see how any face could have got here.
Well, ask him. He's seen it in awe, didn't you?
Me? I never seen nothing. I've just come in.
Well, you know here?
Well, there's certainly nothing there now, Lucille, so if I could get back...
Yeah, if you're sure there's nothing there. Thanks for having a look.
As if I didn't have enough on my plate. Women, gargoyles, faces.
Well, you're here, I thought I might have a word.
What?
About the staffy. The staff dance. I thought that you and I...
Jack!
Only asked a simple question. What was you wee shite? You gave that lassie a hell of a fright.
I thought I told you to stay in there. I could have been Wally Curry there.
Where's my clothes, Phil? You promised to get my clothes!
Look, Sadie's putting a hem up in the blouse.
Eh?
A joke. Here, get in your cupboard. He's a horn spanked. Oh,
shit, don't be crying.
Da 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 da.
Who's under the knife today, Kildare?
It's that young kid that lost both his play pieces in the bus mash, Dr. Gillespie.
What group is he, Kildare?
14th Barhead Life Boys.
Hey, watch, this is new.
Hey, wait, you wearing it for?
To protect my blazer, of course.
Ah! Felt all right, Alan?
Like a glove, Mr. Curry.
Is that the thumb hanging out the back?
Where?
There's magenta and rose pink needed in the design room right away. Jack is on a rush job, and I don't want to see either of your noses poking outside that door until these shades are ready. Capisce?
Plucky Jack and his plucky rush jobs.
Capisce? Capisce?
Once I get that phone call.
I can give you a hand.
No, leave it to the pros, son. You've got something more important to do.
Oh?
Nip down the ladies and ask Sadie for Hex Clobber.
I can't see that that's more important.
Hex Club.
Okay, I think I can manage.
Keep breathing, Heck. We've sent Lord Snooty out for your threads. Soon have you out there, son.
Can a million?
Half a million, don't exaggerate.
Gee, a Parker 51? What's a slippy a boy like that doing my pen like this? Yeah, you know what the first prize is this week? Two matching hamsters.
Hamsters? Are they allowed to give away livestock?
What are you talking about, livestock? Two matching picnic hamsters, handy for beach and country walks.
That was a close shave.
Let's have a gander. Would you look at these? They're like jodhpurs. Look at the shut. What size is Heck?
13 and a half.
No, his chest, stupid, his neck.
3 5/8 with a muffler.
Take these back to Sadie, tell her she'll have to do better.
Well, Mr. Curry's out there.
Heck will look a right palooka in that get up.
He'll hear you.
Can Hector here?
Somebody call.
Jesus! You'll go to the bad fire.
In there, sir.
Hey,
yeah, that was some mess you made of the boy's napper.
I spent an hour trying to get Hector looking like Lucille Dreamboat, Van Johnson.
Yeah, like Van Gogh, the way you went through his ear.
Is it any good, staff dance?
Huh?
The staffy. Is it good fun?
What are you wanting it over?
You don't think you're buying a ticket, are you?
No. Willie Curry's just given me his, a double. He won't be going. So I'll probably bump into you there.
How can you know dance right?
What did you say?
I didn't say anything.
Oh,
God, Hector!
I thought I was going to pass out. Got awful warm in there. Well, what do you think?
Are they comfy?
Aye, but there's just one thing.
Aye, you noticed. It's the very latest, Heck.
Aye, but how do I go for a pee?
Oh, you don't. They're on a pipe doing the leg into a special 10-gallon rubber boot.
You've got them buttoned up the back, you balloon.
Just like Uncle Bertie's.
Eh?
Just like the Hud in the 30s. You must have seen them musicals, Fred Astaire, Dancing with Roy Rogers.
They baited their trousers buttoned up the back.
I never noticed that.
That's cause Fred always wore their long tailcoats and Roy was...
Sitting down.
On trigger.
Hector, it's the knockout.
So do you think Lucille will bite?
Your ma's going to be asking who's the teeth marks are when she gives you your bath tonight.
Nae kidding, Phil.
Nae kidding, Heck.
Extra, I feel like you say.
What?
Well, nothing.
Do you like it?
Yeah, it's really unusual, Hector.
Oh, I go now and ask
her mother. You're not forgetting you have to go and see Willie Curry.
I can do that after.
No, look, Spanks is right. You better see Willie first. It's important. Look, Lucille will no go off the boil. Here, I'll give you my coat to put on.
I want to do that for. I don't mind doing a bit of swanking now that my clays are up to date.
I know, but you don't want him to get a preview, you know, lessen the impact. Here,
oh, aye.
Get a coat on.
Hey!
You better put this on and all. It's awful drafty in Willie's office.
What? Is he not going to think I'm a bit hopped up?
That's just it. You've been down at nurse. Influenza, verging on pleurisy. She ordered you home, but you decided to soldier on. He'll like that.
Oh, Mike, stop. What have I got again?
Double rupture.
Triple pneumonia.
Well, are we a lying then?
That's the stuff. All the best, son.
Good luck, Heck. You'll need it.
I think that's a pretty mean trick.
How do you, by jail?
Look, that poor little bastard's gone off to Willie Curry's office believing that underneath that dust coat and helmet, he really does cut a dash. And he'll probably stop off on his way back to have a word with Lucille. And you know what'll happen then, don't you? She'll wet herself. Which would give you and your crummy friend here a big laugh, wouldn't it?
Listen, Sir Galahad. You know what that stupid mug done? You know what he done? Cause some stupid lassie wouldn't look at the road he was on. He went and swallowed 150 Aspros. Washed down with a bottle of Domestos. What me and Spanks has done
has gie Hector the courage to go and ask Lucille straight out for a day, instead of wishing his life away. So think twice before you start applying your stupid, counterfeit, middle-class code of fair play in here. You don't know your living, sweetheart. And if Willie Curry wants to know where I am, I'm down the bog smoking. Two fags at once.
Is that true about Hector?
Aye, it's true, all right.
Phil found him, brought him round.
No. Happened at a boarding house in Rossie. Small found the note tucked into her beach bag. Made him be sick down the pan. The landlady was quite sympathetic. Till Heck brought up the bleach and took all the floors off the wallpaper.
I'm gonna stop him before he makes a complete fool of himself.
I wouldn't do that if I was you, Alberto. You don't know what Phil's like. He's got some temper. Come on. The magenta's ready. You get some dishes in the sink. The clean ones.
I don't know what I'm doing this for. I'm in a rush job. Farrell, gee, there he
goes. Better give Phil's naw. He's doing the bog.
McCann. Two ends, am I right?
Aye.
McAllister, McBain, McCourtney, McDonald. No, doesn't seem to be anything for him.
Come on, Jackie boy, stop messing
about. Look, I told you, there's nothing for him, look.
Right, geez, Hex.
McFarlane, McInnes, McLaughlin, McLeod. No, nothing for Hector either. There'll be something for you next time, Alan. It won't be a lot, you understand. Oh, I got those mags you wanted to see. Some of your dad's stuff in one of them. Rather nifty. See you anon.
See you later, Jack.
Only that. Two wage packets missing. Hey, I'll have to go along and have a word with the cashier. If Phil comes back, see him away mending a fuse in Miss Walkinshaw's glass eye.
Over there if you want some.
Oh, no, that's not what I'm looking for, thanks. What are you doing that for? That's a mugs game.
I'm really quite enjoying it.
Aye. Do you want chocolate? Go in the spearmint. Usually get double bubble for the Freddy Flair wrappers, but he was getting really annoying. You know, want one? Where have I seen you before?
In here. This morning.
No, apart from that. Did you go to the movies much?
Yeah. Quite a bit. The Kelburn, mostly.
We were there last Saturday. Rebel Be Out of Cause. Did you see it? It was brilliant. It was a double bill we used to have eaten. Me and Bernadette sat through it twice. Absolutely brilliant. Me and her cried our eyes out when his Porsche turned over and he got killed.
No, it was a racing picture.
What?
East of Eden, about cars.
I don't find that amusing. Hasn't taken you long to get into bad habits, has it?
I'm afraid I don't understand.
These are all the same.
I like Terry Dean.
You haven't been saying anything to her, have you? See if you have.
No, I haven't, if you must know. It was just a misunderstanding.
No. That is what you call him, isn't it?
Aye. Miles Mallison. Tragic. There was Miles. Buddy Greco and the big bopper flying down to Rio. Plane crashed.
In the mountains.
The urinals.
Pilot was pissed.
Teaser! There's your dainties. Woo! Chocolate horns,
penny
batch,
Rupert
turnovers.
Rupert turnovers? Oh!
But don't all rush us new. I know you've just been paid.
Come on, Spanky boy. You didn't tell me the wage you was ruined. Make me the green job.
I can lend you 10 bob.
Quit the kidding. I'm starving.
It wasn't anything for you. Teepley said it.
The cashier said you and Hex has been made up special.
Christ!
You listen to that language. You hod your ears, son. Language bloody hellish, so it is. What?
At least you've a drawing college to look forward to. It's Heck, it's a problem. He's only got his ma.
Are you two having something off this trolley?
He's two teas. Do you want one?
What's up with him?
Come on, do you want something to eat?
You know I've no money. What are you asking us for?
I'll get it. You want a chocolate horn? You play old man never on it.
No, want nothing.
He's a bap.
What happens, halfpenny?
But it happens for the tea. The baps are a penny.
You took that long making up your mind that went up. What happens, halfpenny? If you need change, how am I supposed to change a 10 shilling note? They're all giving me notes a day. You'll need to get change. I'll wait. Look, I've only got silver in the boat.
I'll get you tomorrow.
Tomorrow's Saturday and find you note. Do you think I'd come up the Clyde on this trolley? You get change. I'll wait.
Do you have any change, Albert?
I don't know. Wait and I'll see.
Christ, where do you keep that, kid? Up the leg of your brassiere?
One more bit of language out of you and I'll draw my horn across your jaw.
No, I don't seem to have quite that much. I can lend you some if you get a change.
No, no, it's okay. I'll do without.
Do you know what these then? The penny bat? Or the tea?
The tea's cold, the bat's first.
That's because you're stunning asking dirty gubs there if he's wanting anything. Name one of the teas cold.
Wee old midden.
I hear that, you swine. I hear that. One of my boys was here, he'd stuck you off that one, so he went.
That was Sarah, you hit me with your ring.
Oh, you're the big cheese in here, Philip McCann, but just you watch it. Just you mind your manners, right? You'll no talk to me like that. Thanks, son, you're a gent.
Oh,
God.
You put that on it.
She just peed because she missed her dinner doing the alterations to Hex Club. She's at a funny age, you know. Mum was the same. Sunday Post doctor said, nothing to worry about. They all go like that. Good, ain't they?
Yeah, no bad.
Is that Terry Dean?
Hey.
Come on, is it? Terry Dean.
Aye. That's who it is.
The one that was in Rebel Without a Cause in East of Aden.
Suez. East of Suez. Him and Frankie Lane. Race round the Sphinx and Camels for Audrey Murphy's horn. Frankie wins by a nose, so he gets Audrey's horn. Terry gets arrested.
Yeah, I'll go down the bog, Sphinx. Have a drag in it.
You know about to hang about in case your phone call comes through?
No, if it comes, you take it. Just say you're me. I don't think I'm going to hear it anyhow. It's that kind of day. I think I'll go too.
Wonder if my bladder's all right.
Looking for your chum.
Who are you asking for?
Phone call in Mr. Barton's office sounded rather urgent. The girl said it was a hospital.
It's all right, Jackie boy, I'll take it.
I don't think you can do that. She was most insistent she speak to McCann himself.
It's all right, Jack, I'm authorised.
But I don't, it's not, I mean...
Nice sign. Bloody sir, that's my trouble. There's no getting half it this time. 15 shillings, not yet, Lily. Oh, I should trade these in for a set of casters. Any Epsom salts, Hen?
Oh, my God, what'd you do that for?
Listen, you haven't seen Shy Boy McCann in your travels?
Shy?
Aye, 15 bob, Shy. Still owes for that dance ticket.
No again, Sadie. When are you going to wise up? You'll have to wait and catch him outside the town hall tonight.
Oh, I'll not be anywhere near the town hall tonight, Hen. If I thought these were to burl me round a dance
floor. No going then. It's a right laugh last time.
Oh, aye, hysterical. See that man of mine? Watch this, lady, says he. And he sprints the length of the hall with a pint of youngers in his fist. Leapfrogs Miss Wilkinshaw. And a pair of them land right under the bandstand. The bouncer had to winkle him out with a windy pole. Stupid loon. Man, I wouldn't waste my time. I had to take the first one that came along. I'd have been better off with a lucky bag.
Sadie, there's tons of men about now. You can pick and choose.
You'll learn, Flower, you're young yet. You can afford to sift through the dross. To get to the real rubbish at the bottom of the pile. You reach my age, you know, you got to show for it as bad feet in a display cabinet.
That's tough.
Ugh, I'll have to go. Promised Leapfrog I'd get my nice wee bit of fish for his tea. Ugh, well, it's Friday. A bit of luck, he'll be home with half his wages still on him.
Aye, Zane Hoff, by the sounds of it.
I'm biding my time, sweetheart. Once I get a good wee bank book, I show that swine the door. See that? Lost that out of the heat of him.
My God, what did he?
Flung it in the bin.
Eh?
Thought it was one of James's old fit boys that'd get busted. The stupid. Hey, you, where's your pal?
Hey?
Oh, I thought you meant...
Oh, no. Put that off long before I met that sod up at the Western. 15 bob for a dance ticket I'm after.
Aye.
Mr. Anderson, big strap man, he'd surgeon up there. He says that'll have to come away, Miss Jowett, otherwise it'll go right through your heel system. Thanks, you can get it back easier than what I can. Couldn't argue with that, Hen.
Sadie, I thought I'd already gave you that.
Lopsided at first, you know. But I just kept my trolley money in this pocket till I kind of got my balance back.
Ivano gave you that, Sadie?
I went up, you know, 19 elimps for a single.
Used to be only 15 bob.
Aye, but they're made of foam rubber now, son.
Well?
What?
You got a phone call, Jackie boy said.
Oh, aye, for the hospital.
And?
Well, you tell me to say I was you.
Aye, I know, hurry up, tell us.
Well, it was a hospital.
I know that. But tell us the worst.
Your ma's vanished. Shot a craw. Skedaddled.
You mean it really was the hospital?
That's what I'm trying to tell you, Phil.
Christ.
They said not to be alarmed.
What if she turns up here? She'll probably put a hatchet through Miss Walkinshaw's heat just to give me a showing up.
They've sent people out looking for her.
She can be real vicious, you know. She once put the Coleman's legs underneath his lorry and threatened the driver with a breed knife unless he drove over them. Because he was a bag short in the gas cinders. All she ever done was worry. Worry about money, about schools, going to mass, going to communion, missing confessions, going out with lassies. Some bloody hope. All we ever knew about lassies was that their arms stuck out sideways when they ran.
Hey, mate's never more than a bit like that.
I bet you he's, isn't he?
Leave him out of it, Phil. He doesn't even know what you're talking about.
I bet you, doesn't he?
I'm sure you've got your problems, but I don't see where I come in.
Well, it certainly isn't the tradesman's entrance, Petal. Straight up to the front door for you. This way, sir. Let me take your golf club, sir. They must be cutting into your shooter.
Well, I know what I would like to cut into you.
Leave him, Phil.
You stick with his lot, spanky old sport. You always did know what side your Madeira cake was buttered.
That's no fair.
I'm away to join the hunt. And I'll send the heed up for your dad's trophy room. Alan!
You don't want to pay too much attention to Phil. He reads a lot.
That's McCann's wages. Has he got a bonus or something? I've got Hex as well. Right. Hefty wage packets. They've been working overtime, or what? A couple of the chums and I are motoring over to Kippin on Sunday, Alan. Trainspotters AGM. There's a spare seat in the buggy if you'd care to tag along. 3 bob for petrol. The Duke of Athol's coming down from Drumnadrocket on a flyer.
Sounds terrific.
Should be fun. Would you give this to Hector? I think we can trust you.
And what's that supposed to mean, plucky appearance?
Why don't you dry up?
What, you mean like you, Jackie boy? Not bloody likely. You know you can get stuff for that. You rub it all over your plucks. It's cried emery paper.
You'll be glad when today's over, Alan. Him and his crony go a wee bit gaga as the weekend looms. It's the thought of spending 2 whole days with our parents in Figgy. Take my advice. If they start on you, give them a biffin.
Get!
I thought you were away.
I went to Lang to see the lassie about my wages. She said she'd give them to Jack.
Your books?
P45, the lot. Non-contributory pension scheme, what's that?
Means you haven't paid direct.
Shut it, you. I'm talking to my friend. What is it?
How should I know? I've got these dishes to wash. There's hundreds of them. Come on, Phil, he's a honey.
You're forgetting something, Spanky boy. I don't work here anymore.
You never did, Phil.
Yeah, less of the sarcasm, slab boy.
At least I still am one.
Aye, how come? Me and Hector get the heave and you're still here washing dishes, safe and secure. How do you manage it?
I've got work to do, Phil.
Work? Has Noddy or there been getting at you?
Gonna can it, Phil. Me and the boy wants to get cleared up.
Aye, it's me and the boy now, is it?
Aye. What of it?
I think I'm going to be sick.
Oh, well, don't hang over the shades. There's gum in them already.
Thank you.
still here, McCann? You can go anytime, you know.
I'm waiting a phone call.
Only urgent personal calls allowed.
This is urgent. It's for the hospital.
What's up? Somebody else in the family got diarrhea?
It's my ma.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. Are the lacerations severe? Can do a lot of damage, plate glass and short windows.
Who told you about it?
Well, it was written today's Paisley Express. Fergusley Park woman in shop window accident.
Oh, it wasn't an accident. She meant to do it.
But it said in the paper that your mother was thrown through the shop window by a passing car.
Oh, well, they got it wrong then, didn't they? There was a car there, but it was parked. What she done was climb up onto the roof and take a heater straight through the cold window. Simple.
She must have been very badly injured.
Not a scratch.
Good God. For the roof of a car. Must have been a miracle.
Nope. A Ford Prefect.
You're a callow bugger, McCann. As soon as you've got your phone call, you can sling your hook. Okay?
Certainly, Mr. Curry.
Do you think I should have jumped in and asked him for a desk?
You might have been lucky and got your jotters.
Somehow. I'm here for the duration.
Well, play your cards right. Don't give the screws too much cheek. Time off for good behaviour. Who knows? You might get it down to life.
What about Heck?
Now, what about Heck?
He thought he was here for life.
So?
You don't think we ought to put a hat on? Help tide him out to get his brew money?
I'd be helping to tide me out if I get mine.
You've a drawing call to look forward to.
Aye, and my nearest and dearest wandering the fields and hedgerows eating worms.
Come on. Help see the boy's mammy out of the hump.
Out of the hump? There's hardly enough in here to gee Quasimodo a half a bell.
A few, Bob.
A few?
10 will do. Look, I'll match. I'll leave the Christmas club to next week.
Now, don't say I'm no generous. Stupid. But not ungenerous.
Heck will never forget this, Phil.
I never will. It's half my bloody wages.
His faith in human nature will be restored. H. Mackenzie. Slab boy. Retired. Ah, replenishing the old jug of the aqua, I see.
You trying to be foul again?
I was asking if you were getting wetter. It's Italian.
Oh, yeah? Your jug is at half a chip port.
I was wondering.
Here we go again. Yes?
I was wondering if you fancied going to the staff dance with me.
What? Where'd you get them, Sonny? Half the puzzle page of Tiny Tots? Don't make me laugh.
What's wrong with me? You're not going with MD anyhow, are you?
That's where you're wrong. I'm booked. Now, shift the torso.
Hey, where are you going with?
Well, it's neither of yous. All I'm saying is, it's someone for the slab.
For the slab? Think.
The talks have worked.
What did I tell you?
Just been a like to see Wally.
Oh, she went to fly.
She's taking the bundle.
What? Well done, you wee guy.
Wee man, put it there. Nothing, he says.
No, I really get you in faulty, thank. Without yous two, I could never have pulled
not
it up.
Not at all.
Not really. No kidding.
Look, just remember, that's what me and Spanx is here for. Spanx, the presentation.
Why? We've got this.
Quid.
Shut it. You do it.
I'd like to take a moment here for the...
It's a quid.
Shut it.
Here.
Thanks, boys. Really quite touched.
Ah, we know that, Hector.
It means emotionally.
Don't know how yous knew I was leaving the slab room. I've only just been telling me, Willie, but I really do appreciate this.
Quid.
Aye. Oh, come in quite handy.
It helped to tide yous out, you and your ma.
Till you get another job.
Eh?
He says, till you get another job.
Eh?
Till you get another job.
I already got another job.
Christ, that was quick. Is there a mobile brew outside?
That's what I've been a-lying to see Willie about. My new job. I start on a desk on Monday. I'm a designer now.
Designer?
£12 a week backdated a fortnight.
I thought that's what you were congratulating me about.
We were congratulating you about getting a date with Lucille.
Fuck, I was that excited about my desk if I'd go all about her. I'll be gone with Molly anyhow. He hasn't got a ticket.
But she said she was gone with somebody for the slab.
You don't think.
Nah, she couldn't have.
Shall we even get your dad's energy tonight, handsome?
Burton's calling a 1:45. Don't be late now. Sink a couple of Camparis before we get there, eh?
Great.
Oh, Hector, let's go wait for her.
If I were you, Phil McCann, I wouldn't go home via Story Street tonight. That's where Bernadette's boyfriend's got his jujitsu parlour. He eats smouts like you for his breakfast. Don't forget to change out of that blazer. We don't want anybody thinking you're from a bowling club. Okay? Bye.
Well, by the way, a phone call came through to Mr. Curry's office. I said I'd pass the message on.
Aye, is my more safe?
You didn't get in. The standard was especially high this year. Apparently some really top-flight folios. Hard cheese. Where do you see the gum crystals were?
Well, I better shoot off while he's getting his lift up the road. And thanks again, boys.
Oh, hold your horses, heck. If Lucille's got to the dance with gorgeous Gussie there, would you have to thank me and Phil for?
A lot, really. Well, he says that compared to you two slackers, I stuck out a mile in here. That's how I get my desk. Thanks again.
Cool.
And I'll be expecting some smart grinding from this department in the future. No palming me off with your substandard shades, Farrell. And I'm sorry to hear you lost your job, Phil. But no to worry. I don't think you'll find much difference now that you're officially out of work. Well, good night, everybody. I'll see you at the staffy.
Well, mustn't work too late. Not my first day anyway. Wouldn't like to set a precedent. Heavy night ahead, eh? Oh, and tough luck about the art college. Don't take it to heart, eh? It's always next year. Or the year after. Perhaps not. Anyway, see you at the hop tonight. Buy you a small beer. Well, I'll be seeing you on Monday, Sparky. So take it easy over the weekend, eh? Make an early start. It's quite a backlog of grinding to catch up on. That cabinet there is an embarrassment.
That young pup is asking for a severe biffy.
Let's play a merry jape on the shite. Ta-da!
Bravo!
Clint, this is for you, McCann. It was left at the gatehouse. Don't know why I'm doing this. Up to my eyes and apologies. I'm on a first job. Running about the bloody message board.
Your ma?
Phil. Got your mum in the back of the wagon. Managed to get her out of the river without too much difficulty. The grappling hooks did not break the skin. Regards to your dad and tell him Sammy Cairns will see him tonight at Carentyne as usual. All the best, S. Cairns, driver, St. Andrew's Ambulance Service. Thank Christ.
Yeah. At least you know she's back in captivity. I mean, in safe hands. You'll be able to go to the dance now and enjoy yourself.
Aye.
I wonder what she was doing in the river.
Water therapy.
Oh, is Hector not here? Inspector's waiting for me down at the car. Here, there's enough gum there for Jack. I'll just take this out to him. Oh. Wait a moment, there's a foreign body in here.
Has he got a turban on?
You'll just have to make up some fresh stuff, Farrell. Pronto. Mr. Barton's waiting on that job Jack's doing.
I'm just going home, Mr. Curry. I've got the staff dance.
Never mind about that, Larry. The staff dance can wait. Mr. Barton can't. Get the overalls back on and get waving. And you can take that smirk off your face, McCann, and give him a hand. Come on, the muslin is down there. Come on, look alert. If I'd had you chaps in the tropics.
Wally Curry. I don't work here anymore, remember? And while we're at it, you can drop all that gibbing shit about the jungle. Jimmy Robertson blew the gaff. The only thing you've ever hacked your way through was a battalion's pay slips. You fighting the Japs. You've never been further east than the China stall at the Barras.
Chewy spivvy.
And just what did you geese about for anyhow? Wasn't it for the cheek I gave you? We've all done that. Wasn't it for loafing about either? That's de rigueur in here. What really got you by the curlies was the thought of me. Me. Gone to the art school, wasn't it?
that I might just have the savvy to realise there was more to life than giving myself housemaid's bloody knee and then stabs.
Since the day and hour you have walked in that door, McCann, you have tried to call the legs from under me. Well, it's your turn now. Oh, yes, I wish it had been me that gave you your cards, but Mr. Barton beat me to the punch. Get that lazy young bastard out of here, Curry, or I'll have your gaffer stripes before you can say Super Sax three quarter squares. I'll set you back a bit, huh? Muckins here even asked for a second chance for you. Me, for you. And as for the art school, that's your best joke yet. Scoffing cheap wine with the old masters in the Doss house. It's about your level. Right. And as for Jimmy Roberts, he's got hammer toes. He couldn't even dig for victory.
Plucky Jack and his plucky rush jobs. Just wait till I get my desk. Just wait. What a bally day, Cherry.
Buck up, Nugent. Reckon one ought to throw one's fairy cycle over a dike and leg it back to fairyland. See what the pater's got for one's tea the night. A few grains of jolly fine mince, perhaps. Might stop off and buy the old buffer a couple of big screw taps. Cheer the wee bastard up. The day started off in a high note. One's mater off for a few days in the country. But bless my boater if they both haven't taken a dip since then. Do you think Giotto ever was a slab boy, Spanks?
A white sport coat and a pink carnation.